Welcome to South East Today. I'm live in Brighton for a special programme tonight following the visits of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex to Sussex.
Harry was like giving us all high fives and then Meghan was shaking our hands.
I'm not washing this hand again!
The crowds turned out in force to catch a glimpse of Harry and Meghan as they visited both a rape crisis centre and the Royal Pavilion.
It is a woman of colour entering the royal family and for what that boy's been through. That's what it means. It's a personal thing for me as a woman of colour who lives in Brighton. Don't make me cry, boy.
I'm in Peacehaven, where the whole town turned out to greet the royal couple as they arrived at the youth centre to chat to dozens of teenagers.
Welcome to the programme, a special edition of South East Today. I'm live in Brighton here at the Royal Pavilion, a scene of calm and quiet now, but a little earlier today there were hundreds of people thronging, as well as security people everywhere, for the visit of Harry and Meghan, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. It was their first visit to their namesake county since the pair got married back in May, and they've enjoyed a really mixed day today. They visited a rape crisis centre, as well as a youth centre and the Royal Pavilion here, to inspect the newly restored Grand Saloon. Our first report does contain some flash photography because, as Piers Hopkirk reports, everywhere the royal couple have been, they've had an enthusiastic welcome.
They packed the streets, filling any vantage point to grab a glimpse. The sea of mobiles showing that the royal couple had arrived. For the thousands that had come here, the chance to see in the flesh one of the most famous and one of the most photographed couples on the planet.
She's stunning. Absolutely stunning. That's about... just a bit gobsmacked myself.
I didn't see too much, to be honest. She's watching much better from here, you
know? It's great. It's a bit of excitement in Brighton, isn't it? I love it.
So 5 months after their titles were bestowed upon them, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex are here, home as it were, at last, and what a reception they're being given. And for these children from Brighton's Queen's Park School, a moment they'll treasure forever. High fives with the Prince.
It's my dream come true. I've been waiting to do this all my life.
We talked about our favourite subjects and how and what we thought they had in their palace.
That's a very good answer.
It was unbelievable, really. I never thought this would happen.
And will you ever forget? Will you ever forget today?
No.
It was a dream come true because I've never met them.
It was absolutely stunning and amazing.
And what did you think?
It was nice because Harry was like giving us all high fives.
I'm not washing this hand again!
First port of call, Brighton's Royal Pavilion. Even for the royals, a palace like no other. Prince George's Pleasure Dome, revisited by a new royal generation.
It was hugely exciting. I was a little bit nervous, to be honest, but it all went incredibly smoothly and it was terribly enjoyable.
It's only the second Duke of Sussex ever to be in this building, but the first Duke only visited twice, and we're hoping that the second Duke visits rather more frequently.
Then from the pavilion, the short walk to Brighton's Survivors Network charity, supporting people who've experienced sexual violence and abuse.
It felt to me that what they're going to take away is the hard work, the important work that Survivors Network does as a charity for survivors of sexual violence.
So for the Duke and the Duchess and the crowds who came to see them, a day to live long in the memory. Piers Hopkirk, BBC South East Today, Brighton.
Well, let's have a chat with a couple of people who've been involved with everything that's been going on today. Jay Breslaw, you're with the Survivors Network. They came to see the work that you do here in the city. And I know it's a really important day for you, the work that they put in to come and visit.
Absolutely. We're absolutely delighted to have them come and visit. And what we're especially pleased around is that they were speaking to service users and volunteers, as well as staff. And we were so impressed by how empathetic they were and the really interested questions they asked of us.
Because, of course, Harry's mother, Diana, she never shied away from getting involved in charities that were perhaps involving marginalised people or people who the rest of society didn't pay too much attention to.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. And we're a small charity. We are the Rape Crisis Centre for Sussex, but still we're still a small charity. And the exposure that it's going to give us is absolutely phenomenal. And we are so delighted and pleased with that.
Okay, let's have a chat with Dee Simpson as well. You're the mayor of Brighton at the moment. You were in the lineup today when they came through.
I was in the civic lineup along with the Lord Lieutenant and the High Sheriff.
And I mean, you've got all the, you know, the trappings of dignitary on there, but it's a really impressive thing when you actually meet a royal like that, isn't it?
Absolutely. It was so wonderful. It was such a wonderful day for the city. I mean, the people in the city turned out in their thousands probably, and the atmosphere was amazing. It was electric.
And when you say that it's an important day for the city, in what way do you think it is important? In terms of tourism, those kind of things?
Absolutely. I think when people see this go out over the media, they'll see what a wonderful city we've got in Brighton and Hove. Mm-hmm. And I know Harry and Meghan enjoyed it. The people were so friendly towards them, and they were so friendly back.
And give us a little insight. What were they actually like to meet as people?
They were lovely.
Yeah.
Honestly, they were so genuine and friendly, and really, we were quite nervous before they came, I have to be honest, but they really put us at ease, and that was fantastic.
Great stuff, Jake, Dee. Thank you both very much for being with us. Well, I'll be back with a little more later in the programme, but for the moment, back to the studio and Charlie Rose.
Rob, thank you very much. Well, it's just gone 20 minutes to seven. This is our top story tonight. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have made their first official visit to the county that features in their royal titles. During the eagerly anticipated trip, the couple met large crowds in Brighton and Peacehaven, visited charities and were treated to musical performances.
And the sun shone on the royals today, but how will the rest of us fare through the rest of this week? I'll give you all the details later on in the programme.
Well, that's it for me here in the studio. Time to go back to our main story. And the Duke and Duchess of Sussex went on their first visit to the county today, visiting Brighton and Peacehaven. But first, let's go to Rob back in Brighton. Rob, over to you.
Charlie, thank you very much. Well, we've come around to the other side of the pavilion for the moment, the pavilion garden size. Behind me, you can see what they call the Indian Gate here. That is where Harry and Meghan came through a little earlier today from the royal car, and this whole area was absolutely thronged with thousands of people. You may have seen in Piers's VT a little earlier that there was a group of children from Queen's Park Primary School just over there. They spoke to every single one of those pupils individually, asked them their name and what they did, spent a good 10 minutes with them. That won an awful lot of hearts and minds during the course of today here, I can tell you. And it doesn't matter whether you're a royalist or if you're a cynic about the whole of this kind of a thing, because I have to say that the atmosphere here today was really warm and generous and friendly, and it was very difficult not to get caught up in it. Once Harry and Meghan had been into the Royal Pavilion, taken a look round and then come out, just a few moments after, while all that buzz was still going on, I had a chat with as many people as I could to see what they made of it all. Were you at the front? Did you get to see them?
Yeah.
We got a wave.
He waved at us.
He waved at you?
Yeah. She got on my shoulder.
Yeah.
Did he actually talk to any of you at all?
No, he's just like waving, just saying hi, girls.
And seeing Meghan then, what does that mean to you?
So much. So much. As a woman of colour entering the royal family and for what that boy's been through. That's what it means. It's a personal thing for me as a woman of colour who lives in Brighton. Don't make me cry, boy.
you're going to make me cry. Did you like it?
I loved it.
Right. Why? What did you think?
I thought she looked very beautiful.
What happened?
She just came along and she shook hands with us. And we said, welcome to Brighton, Your Royal Highness. And she thanked us. And I said, thank you for bringing the sunshine. She had a laugh about that.
So you gave them some flowers?
I did, yeah. I think it's just nice that they've made the effort to come to Brighton, and it's not every day you get to meet a princess, is it?
So no.
Why not?
What did you make of her?
I thought she was really beautiful and smiley.
Very graceful.
And even though they've probably had such a long day, they still made an effort to smile and wave at everyone.
We're front row, got a shaky handy moment with Harry.
And Rob asked for a cuddle.
Asked for a cuddle, but I didn't get one, unfortunately. But well, he did like my hat.
He did.
Which we wore specially for him.
I spent all morning here for 5 hours now. So it's really, really a pleasure.
And was it worth it?
Every minute. Bad photos, but every minute of it, yes.
Now, I have to say, people really did get caught up in it. It was a good, fun atmosphere to be involved in. Somebody who was involved in what was going on today on an official level is Charlie Knight. Now, you're actually with the Sea Cadets here, but you are the Lord Lieutenant's Cadet, and you were actually part of the greeting party here.
Yeah, I got a email not too long ago saying there was a surprise royal engagement, and after the wedding, almost guessed who it was, but yeah, I went down to the town hall and met the Lord Lieutenant for the morning, and then we came down and was ready for the event.
And today you shook hands with Harry?
Yeah, us and my other two colleagues were stood over there, and we didn't think he'd speak to us. We thought we were just sort of there for the looks, but he came over and said hello to all of us and shook our hands.
And this is the thing everybody says, they're very warm and personable when you actually have a chat with them.
Yeah, I didn't know whether they were sort of going to be quite snobby, but they were really friendly and they're just normal people, really.
Great stuff. And are you hoping to have a career in the Navy when you're a bit older? You're 17 now, aren't you?
Yeah, and eventually after I finish college, Royal Marines, maybe Navy, and see where that takes me.
And I know, because I had a chat with your mum earlier on today, she was getting quite emotional about it all.
Yeah, she's always there, always the one crying.
Great stuff, Charlie, thank you very much. Let's have a chat with a couple of real fanatics as well. Camilla Gerber, you have camped out for the Harry and Meghan's royal wedding. You made sure you were here today.
I made sure I was here today. I had to, and my friend Leo told me just last week about today. I didn't know anything about that they were going to visit.
But it was lovely to see them.
It was lovely to see them again. And I even got to shake Harry's hand and give him my bouquet of flowers.
Oh, fantastic.
And I go to all the royal events. And
love Leo, I know you go with them as well, don't you?
Yeah, we've been Sandringham and Windsor.
Why?
And
why are you such a strong royalist? What's the appeal?
We need it. They keep the country together. And these are the modern royals. And they're the people's royals. They're very, very, probably meet them in the pub type of people. Yeah, really, really nice. And
excellent.
They've got time for everybody.
Leo, thank you very much. Okay, so let's take a look at what's been going on with lots of social media reaction during the course of today, because loads of you have been tweeting your pictures and sending in your videos. Becca Ayres, for instance, she took a picture of Prince Harry in Brighton today. Naomi Pope captured a lovely shot of Meghan when she was in Peacehaven. And Phil Elms was at the entrance of the Royal Pavilion when Prince Harry was coming through there. You can see lots more of those pictures online, of course. You can always go to bbc.co.uk/Sussex or go on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, use the hashtag Harry and Meghan. Well, of course, it wasn't all about Brighton. It was Peacehaven as well. Natalie Graham has been over in Peacehaven today following the action there. Natalie.
Oh, Rob, I tell you what, we're all still on a bit of a high here. Today has been a big deal for Peacehaven. I reckon the whole town came out at 3:30 to see the royal couple arrive here at the Joff Youth Centre. The schools had just broken up for the day, so most of the children of the town got a chance to witness a bit of local history. I think it's fair to say there was a bit of surprise in Peacehaven when they found out that Harry and Meghan were going to make this part of their royal itinerary today. And people were asking, why are they bothering to come here? But you know what? We're really grateful that they did. Now, I was outside with the crowds. I only got to see the back of Harry's head, but my colleague Amanda Acas was inside for the royal visit.
It felt like the whole of Peacehaven gathered around the town's youth centre today, desperately hoping to catch a glimpse of the royal couple.
I love Harry and I want to see his wife. I've always liked him from a little boy.
I've seen her on TV, but I've never seen her in real life. I wanted to come here.
A chance for them to see history. Might not get to do it again.
Well, we're expecting the Duke and Duchess of Sussex to arrive here at the Joff Youth Centre in Peacehaven any minute now. Huge crowds have come out to meet them. The police say several thousand people are here.
And then the cheers rang out as they arrived. The royal couple were greeted by 50 local teenagers who gathered to talk to them about mental health and share some of their own experiences.
They were so nice and friendly. When I come over, Prince Harry gave us like his life experiences of like how it was like through mental health for him.
He definitely pointed out specifically bereavement because of course of his loss, and I mean it was interesting to know that he had a lot of knowledge on mental health and how to deal with it, and I don't know about anyone else, but it definitely surprised me.
And it seems one member of the local youth club made a big impression.
Harry came over after and he gave me a massive hug and danced with me, and I was literally like starstruck, so I couldn't even say anything. The nicest people ever, and yeah, I'm so happy I met them and got to speak to them. Well, tried to speak to them.
Peacehaven gets left out. It's a small town and usually they bypass it and go to Brighton, and now Peacehaven's on the map, and it's about the young people in Peacehaven, the community, and also promoting what we do here as a youth club and around mental health awareness.
The crowds outside were rewarded for their patience as the Duke and Duchess made their way out. For Peacehaven, a town only just over a century old, it's a day which will go down in history.
Who's this?
Amanda Akas, BBC South East Today, Peacehaven.
So when Harry and Meghan first arrived here, one of the things that wasn't filmed by all the press today was a private conversation they had with a couple of the people we're going to have a chat with now. James, how was it for you?
It was quite a surreal experience, to be honest, but getting your voice heard is what matters, really. So.
And you had a particular message you really wanted to get across to Harry and Meghan today.
Yeah, I think transgender people like myself need a voice, and if I can help get that across, then that's the best thing to come out of it for me. So.
And you felt you could really talk to them?
Yeah, they were so nice and down to earth, and just they really connected with you, not just, you know, being royalty, but just like normal people would. So.
And Kai, you said the same, didn't you? You told me, what did you tell me about if you'd seen them on the street?
Basically that if I actually met them on the street, I would think them as just a normal couple instead of royalty. They're so down to earth and very understanding.
Yeah, they were good to talk to, were they? Yeah, well done. I know it's been a very exciting day. We've been, it was funny, outside of the crowds, you know, I thought everyone would be excited to meet Meghan, but there was a lot of chanting for Harry. But you, Emma, you got to meet Meghan, and that was the result you wanted today.
Yeah, I do like Harry, but Meghan's my favourite, so
yeah.
That's right.
So tell me about her then, and tell me how it felt to meet her.
At first it was really surreal because I was like, oh my God, it's Meghan Markle, I've seen your wedding and everything. So it was a bit weird. But then like after a while, she was so down to earth, like the guys were saying, she was just like really easy to talk to. So she was very lovely and very smiley.
Lovely. Well, thanks to everyone who joined us here today. We're all still coming down from the excitement. It's been a lovely sunny day. John Hammond, who I gather is in Brighton. John, what's the forecast like for the rest of the week?
Well, Natalie, yes, as you say, the sun is setting on a glorious day here in Brighton. Just as the sun sets, of course, the pavilion is lit up fantastically through this evening. It has been a lovely day here, not for all of us across the region. For some, it stayed rather cloudy, but for all of us, it has been mild. And for the next few days, we keep that mild theme going. And I'm pretty hopeful that we'll all see some sunshine at some stage. Then a change come the weekend. We'll see a splash of rain. Now, it won't be a washout. Back to the here and now, though, you can see most of the rain is way to the north of us, and that's the way it'll stay really over the next few days. For us, we're dry with those balmy westerly winds coming in, and that's the way it'll be through this evening and overnight. We'll keep that mild feed of air. The cloud will come and go, but I think it will stay dry throughout the night. It might turn a touch misty as we head towards dawn, but any fog shouldn't be too widespread, and temperatures won't fall all that much, around about 12 or 13 as a low. So tomorrow we start off misty in a few spots, but that mist won't hang around. I think it'll soon clear, and then a day quite similar to today's, really, the sun coming and going, but most of us will see some brightness, and it should stay dry, and it will be mild, temperatures up into the high teens again. Looking further ahead, well, we keep the rain to the north of us for the time being, but eventually as we head towards the weekend, so that rain heads in our direction, so we'll see some rain come Saturday. That's your forecast. Back to you, Rob.
Okay, John, thank you very much. Well, the light is starting to go, but it's all looking quite dramatic here. It's been an eventful day across Sussex, not just here in Brighton, but in Peacehaven as well. We'll be back with the programme as usual tomorrow, but for the moment, we'll leave you with some memories and images of an eventful day in Sussex. Good night.
Fantastic couple, they're doing such good for our country.
I'm not pushing this hand again.